Hello viewers, welcome to our UNC digital class. Myself Rasmita Jena, lecturer in computer science. Today I am going to discuss the introduction to transaction system. In our previous video, we have already discussed about some introductory part of the transaction system, that is definition of transaction, different characteristics of a transaction, and what is concurrency control. And why we need concurrency control. These are the various points we had already discussed. And in today's class, we will discuss the rest part of the introduction as well as the transaction and its states and the role of the recovery manager, and then last the system log and commit point of a transaction. So let's have a discuss on introduction to transaction. This is the today content. Introduction to transaction and system concept. We have to read under these that why recovery is needed, the transaction state, the system log, and commit point of a transaction. So first we will discuss why recovery is needed, or we can say what is the cause to transaction fail. That means what are the various reason or what is the situation where a transaction may unable to continue. Okay, so we know system crash, this is a very common mode among the users of the computer, that in some time the system's hardware and software may not function. Okay, so at that time that may be a system failure or system crash. Okay, and when a hardware is not functioning, that it means what? The data which are stored in the internal memory of the hardware, that may be lost. But if the software is not functioning or software is lost, then at that time we may repair that software, or the transaction fail and we may repair that software for the further use. So the first point of the transaction failure is system crash. Okay, you can see a computer failure or system crash means a hardware or software error occur in the computer system during transaction execution. That means when we are executing our transaction, at the same time maybe a hardware or software error occur, and if the hardware crashes, the content of the computer's internal memory may be lost. This is the first reason why a transaction is to be failed. Then second is your transaction or system error. Transaction or system error means we know that when we are going to divide a integer number by zero, then it will return a error. That is a system error. And also when we are putting a integer value which is beyond the integer range, then at that case there is a system error, that is integer overflow. Okay, so these are the some examples of the system error, that is some operation in the transaction may cause it to fail, such as integer overflow or division by zero. The transaction failure may also occur because of erroneous parameter value or because of a logical programming error. We can say in addition to, the user may interrupt the transaction during its execution. It means what? User may interrupt the transaction during its execution. As we already discussed about the concurrency execution of the transaction, that means at the concurrence execution we have only one CPU, but there are more than one process is to be execute in that particular CPU. In that time one transaction may wait for a long period of time for getting the CPU. Okay, and the transaction which wait for a long period of time, that transaction may interrupt the executed transaction. Okay, and when that transaction is interrupted, then at that time the executed transaction may left the processor. Okay, that is the one reason why a transaction is failed. Okay, then next we will come to the third reason of the transaction failure, that is your local error or exception condition detected by the transaction. Local error or exception condition detected by the transaction means, here we can take one simple example of local error. That is, we all are operating ATM for the retrieval of money. Okay, sometime you can see that we are putting a amount to the ATM for retrieving the amount, suppose that is 2000, but in our account suppose the balance is 1000. So in that time we are unable to retrieve that amount that per our requirement, because we don't have sufficient money in our account. That is also one reason for the failure of the transaction. You can say this is a local error or this is a exception condition detected by the transaction. So certain condition necessitate cancellation of the transaction. For example, data for transaction may not be found. That means we have 100 rupees in our account, but we give the query for the 2000 rupees. That means the condition such as insufficient account balance in the banking database, which may cause a transaction fail, and that is called as the fund withdrawal from that account is to be cancelled, and that lead to a failure of a transaction. Okay, so these are the three reasons why a transaction is to be failed. The next is concurrency control enforcement. As we already know about concurrency execution means what? The concurrency control method means that may decide to abort transaction to be restart later. That means we already discussed, if you have one CPU and there are more than one process is to be executed, then in some cases the transaction which is executed that may abort and to be restart later because of it violates the serializability or because of several transactions are in the state of deadlock. Okay. That means due to the time limit or due to the priority or due to the serializability, a transaction may forcefully abort from the execution and to be restart later, and the processor may assign to the transaction which is in deadlock for a long period of time. So this is the fourth reason why a transaction is to be fail. Okay. The next come to the fifth reason, that is disk failure. We know that when we are inputting the data to the disk block, okay, when we are inputting data to the disk block, this input and output, or you can say read and write operation, can possible through the read write head of the disk drive. If that read write head is unable to function, then in that case the disk may failure to read the data from the disk or to write the data to the disk. So in that case the transaction may not able to read or write data. Okay, so that is the one reason when the transaction is unable to read or write, the transaction may lead to failure. Okay, so disk failure is the next reason for the failure of a transaction. Okay, so next, the last reason of the transaction failure is the physical problem or catastrophic problem. Okay, so the last reason is physical problem and catastrophic problem. So physical problem and catastrophic problem means that refers to an endless list of problem that include power failure, air condition failure, fire catch of the system, that the system may theft. So these are the some catastrophic problems arises during transaction, and that this reason may lead to the failure of a transaction. Okay, so for the transaction failure, these are the some reasons, and beside this we have some lot of reasons that we will discuss in later time. So next we will discuss what is transaction, what are the system concept, and what is the transaction state. Transaction means that is a atomic unit of work that is either completed in its entirely or not done at all. That means transaction means here we are taking some atomic unit of work. Okay, that is either completed entirely, that means the transaction will begin and end successfully, that is the transaction completed its entirely, or not done at all means it doesn't start. Okay, so that is the transaction. Then what are the different states of the transaction? Different states of the transaction are there, that is active state, partially committed state, fail state, and terminated state. Active state means when a transaction start, then it will be go for the active state, and at the active state it will do its read write operation. And when successfully the transaction read or write, then the transaction go for the partially committed state. And in the partially committed state, the transaction will check for the all transaction operations are done properly and perfectly. Otherwise, from the partially committed state, if there is some mistake, then we may roll back. Okay? But once at the partially committed state, we ensure about that the transaction is successfully committed, then we will go for the committed state. And at that time, I like to say that once we go for the committed state and we commit the transaction, then we can further roll back. Okay? This is the one way or one path of the transaction. And the next path of the transaction is from the active state. If the transaction is failed to read or write operation, then the transaction is go for the fail state. And from the fail state, it will go for the terminated state. And from the committed state, it will also go for the terminated state. We will discuss with a block diagram. So these are the definition of the active state, partially committed state, fail state and terminated state. A transaction goes in the active state immediately after it starts execution, where it can execute a read write operation. You can see the block diagram. This is the block diagram. You can see here the begin of the transaction, and in the begin transaction, the transaction will go for the active state. Okay. From the active state, the transaction do its read write operation. Okay. In the active state, the transaction do its read write operation, and after successfully completing the read write operation, then that is the execute the end of the transaction. This is the beginning of the transaction. It indicates start of the transaction. End of the transaction means it indicates end of the transaction. When the transaction successfully done all its operation, then the transaction is go for the partially committed state. Okay. Then from the partially committed state, when a transaction ends its active state operations, then it moves to the partially committed state. It means at this point, some recovery protocol needed to ensure that the system failure will not result in ability to record change of the transaction permanently. That means at the partially committed state, if the user want to some modification in the transaction, then the user can do. Because you can see this is the point that the system failure will not result in an inability to record the changes of the transaction permanently. Okay. You can see the block diagram. From this location, active location to active state 2, it will go for the partially committed state. And from the partially committed state, if it is aborted, then go for the failed state. Or you can see from the active state, if it is failed to read or write, that means if the disk failure occur, then it will be failed and aborted and go for the failed state. Okay. But if at the partially committed state, the transaction successfully completed, then it will go for the committed state. And at the committed state, the transaction committed. That means we can't further roll back for the modification. Okay. You can see once this check is successful, the transaction is said to have reached its commit point and entered to the committed state. Okay. And when the transaction is committed, it has concluded its execution successfully and all its changes must be recorded permanently in the database even if a system failure occurs. That means if the system failure occurs, then after we can't also go for the modification. Okay. Then that means after committed state, we'll go for the terminated state. Okay. The transaction may then have to roll back to undo the effect of its write operation on the database, and the terminated state correspond to the transaction leaving the system. So terminated state indicate now we leave the system or now we leave the processor. Okay. But you can see if the transaction is fail at the active state or at the partially committed state, then it will be aborted and go for the fail state. Okay. So in fail state, A transaction can go to the failed state. That means if one of the check fails or if the transaction is aborted during active state. From the failed state, the transaction go for the terminated state. It indicates that the time to leave the system. Okay. So this is the block diagram of the whole transaction process and the functions of the transaction states. Okay. Then next we will know if the transaction fail. Okay. If the transaction is fail, then what is the role of a recovery manager? The role of the recovery manager, if the transaction fail, the recovery manager may perform this following operations. That is, begin transaction, the recovery manager have to check. This is the mark of the beginning of the transaction execution. That means the transaction successfully begin. The next, read or write operation. This specify read or write operation on the database item that are executed as part of a transaction. Okay. Then next, the recovery manager will check the end of the transaction. This specifies that read-write transaction operation have ended and mark the end limit of the transaction execution. That means recovery manager will check begin transaction, that then the read-write operations are successfully done by the transaction or not. Then if the recovery manager found that end transaction is also executed, it means the read-write transaction operation have ended and marked the end limit of the transaction execution. At this time, the recovery manager may be necessary to check whether the changes introduced by the transaction can be permanently applied to the database or whether the transaction has to be aborted. That means at the end of the transaction, the recovery manager will check that the changes which is made by the transaction can be permanently applied to the database. That means it execute the commit statement or not. Whether the transaction has to be aborted, that means if it is not executed commit, whether the transaction is to be aborted because it violate the concurrency control or some other reason, that will be checked by the recovery manager. Okay, then the recovery manager, after checking this, then check for the commit transaction state. This is the signal which indicate that the successful end of the transaction. That means if the transaction execute commit transaction statement or the transaction committed, then it indicate the transaction successfully complete. Okay, so that any change execute by the transaction or any change that is done by the transaction can be safely committed to the database and will not be undone. Okay, that means if it is permanently stored the change information into the database, then will not be undone. Okay, then next part is a rollback. That means if the transaction is not executed committed transaction, the data which is changed by the transaction are not permanently stored in the system, then the recovery manager will roll back or abort. Okay, this is the signal that the transaction has end unsuccessfully. Commit transaction means the signal indicate the transaction end successfully. Roll back or abort means the signal that indicate the transaction has end unsuccessfully. Okay, so that any change or effect that a transaction may have applied to the database must be undone. Then we will discuss the system log. System log means it keeps track of all transaction operations that affect the value of the database item. The information may be needed to permit the recovery from the transaction failure. That means when a transaction is failed, the system log, the importance of system log is arise. That means the system log records all the operations on the transaction and the log periodically back up to the archival storage to guard against such catastrophic failure. If there is any failure, Then, as we know, log periodically back off the information about the transaction, so we can recover the information where the transaction is failed. Okay, so these are the some log records may system log execute. So these are start transaction T. It means the record that transaction T has started execution. Okay, the next is your write item T X old value comma new value. It means in transaction T we are going for the write operation and the data item is X and we will change a old value to new value for the data item X. Records that transaction T has changed the value of data item X from old value to new value. Exactly, read item comma T X means record the transaction T has read the value of database item X. It means what? Transaction T read the value of X from the data item. Okay, then commit T records that transaction T has completed successfully and that if that it effect can committed to the database, then that means the effect can be committed or recorded permanently to the database. Then last log statement is abort T. If the system failure, then this will be execute, that is records that the transaction T has been aborted. Okay, if we write this, then it indicate the failure of transaction. If we write this, then it indicate committed of the transaction. If you write this in the system log, then it means it read a item from the transaction, read item from the database through the transaction. If you write this statement, write TX old value new value, it means it write a old value for the data item X to the new value, and start transaction T means that is the start of the transaction. So this is all about the log record or system log informations. Okay, then last part of the transaction, that is commit point of a transaction. Commit point means, as we already discussed about, a transaction T reaches its commit point when all its operation that access database have been executed successfully and the effect of all transaction operation on the database has been recorded in the log permanently, and the transaction that write an entry commit T into the log, it indicate that the transaction is at committed point, or it indicates the transaction is said to be committed and its effect is assumed to be permanently recorded in the database. Okay, so this is all about your transaction and different states of the transaction, that is active state, partially committed state, committed, failed state and abort state. Then we will discuss what are the recovery manager roles. Then next we have discussed that what is system log and what different informations are recorded in the system log. Then next last our commit point of the transaction, where the transaction is said to be committed and the change which is made by the transaction are permanently stored in the database. Thank you. Have a nice day.